The first thing your dream client sees when they land on your website at the top is the header, and at the very bottom is the footer. So they need to be used and set up strategically to work really well for your website. In this video, I'm diving deep into what should be included, what shouldn't be included, as well as best practices. Let's go. Hi, I'm Allie, and I teach visual marketing strategies to help you get your business up and running online with a standout brand and website. And by making use of your header and footer on your website, it may be really important in helping you stand out online. Now, you may be thinking, yeah, headers and footers are just places for navigation and maybe social media links. But the truth is, if you're not strategically using these areas, you may be missing out on a really great opportunity to make another connection with your audience. So let's start out by talking about your branding. Your header is the first thing at the very top of your website and the first thing someone sees when they land there. And because it will be repeated on every page, it's really important that you clearly and consistently show your brand logo as well as your brand's personality through the color and typography that you use. Your header should also house your primary navigation for your website. I recommend that you keep your navigation to find 5 links or less. Think about it. For every link that you remove, it makes the remaining links stand out that much more, right? So your viewer will be less overwhelmed and also more likely to actually find what they're looking for and click on it. Psychology shows that things in the first and last position get the most attention. So be sure to use that information and put your most important links in the first and last position inside of your navigation. Another great thing that you can do inside of your header is to reinforce what it is that you want your dream client to do next in the form of a call to action. So think about the most important goal for your website. If it's to have your dream client call you, then you should add your phone number. If you want to have them email you, be sure to add your email address inside of your header. Maybe you want them to download your freebie so that you can start growing your email list, or maybe you want them to schedule a strategy call with you. If that's the case, then you should add a button inside of your header. But what about how your header behaves? Traditional, transparent, sticky? What are all of these options? Well, a traditional header scrolls off the page as you scroll down. A transparent heading has no background behind it, so overlays the hero banner below. Or it can be a semi-transparent header, like this example. A sticky header is one that fixes to the top of the browser as you scroll down the page. There are partially sticky headers as well, like this one, where the top row call to action stays in view as you scroll down the page, but the navigation doesn't stick. All right, now let's talk about your footer. Your footer is also extremely important because it's the last thing you're going to say to your viewer. So if your dream client has scrolled all the way down to the bottom of your website, that's usually a good sign that they're really interested in what you have to offer and learning more about how you can help them. Also, your eyes naturally stop and take a break when you get down to the bottom of the page. So the footer should not be discounted when it comes to designing your site. You can show your call to action again, or maybe repeat some of the most important links from your main navigation in your footer. Another great idea is to give another way that someone can continue to learn more about you. Maybe connect with you via your social media links or in a Facebook group. Or another thing you can do is promote your freebie here as well. What's most important about your header and footer is that they're consistent throughout all the pages of your website. The one exception is for landing pages, such as an email opt-in landing page or a sales page. On those pages, it's best not to give your viewer any other place to link off of that page, because that page is all about getting them to do the one thing you're asking them to do, either sign up for your opt-in or buy what you're selling on your sales page. So now that you know how to get your header and footer working well and looking really good for your site, you might be wondering other ways that you can improve your website. And if that's the case, click the video that's on your screen right now where I go over 5 ways to refresh your website. And if you're loving all these tips and tactics on how to grow your business online, be sure to click subscribe and the little notification bell so that you get notified the next time my video goes live. I'll see you next time.